Fireside, the best grilling shop in town. Fireside, I think I'm gonna go on down.
Hi, this is Greg with Fireside Outdoor Kitchens. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about how to control the temperature in your ceramic grill or Kamado grill. When I refer to ceramics or Kamados, I'm talking about all of them. They're a type of grill. So whether you have a Golden's Cast Iron, a Kamado Joe Ceramic, Big Green Egg, Primo, Vision, Sapphire, whatever, they all work basically the same way. And you could even lump Weber's into that pool too. Essentially, these are products that work by clean air flow. So the first thing that's going to be important is that your grill be relatively clean on the inside. By that, I do not mean the cooking grates and the inside of the grill body. I mean at the bottom of the grill where the air is flowing through the inside of the bottom of the charcoal area, that needs to be open and clean. So between uses, you need to get the old ash out of there and never use any kind of paper to light your grill because it will clog up airflow. So once you're sure you've got good clean airflow, the second issue is going to be understanding how much the grill should be open to control different temperatures. So first, I would say use Kamado Joe's if you have it, Kamado Joe's cap. It has a really good guide on it. You can see here that they basically have these lines drawn, there's four of them. So if you're going to use this grill for low temperature, try mimicking the amount of openness here and the amount of openness here when you first start using the grill. If you want a higher temp, then give it more airflow here and mimic that down here. So use the intake and the exhaust, if you will, with equal amounts of openness or closedness to help you control the temperature. I would say the biggest mistake that we hear about here in the store is that people come in and say that they're trying to do really hot cooks or high temperature cooks, so they're using a lot more charcoal than usual. Or they're trying to do a low and slow cook, so they use a lot less charcoal than usual. In my earlier video about how to use charcoal and how much to put in the grill, I mentioned always use the same amount, and this is why. One, you're not being wasteful. These grills are extremely efficient. If you have extra charcoal, you're going to close the grill, shut it down, and you can reuse the charcoal. So use the same amount every time. That will allow you to become very good at understanding where your openness settings should be for different temperatures. The second issue is going to be that people frequently will use the grill with the lid open too much. They're accustomed to a Weber or some other type of charcoal grill, and they're accustomed to having the lid open a lot. Keep in mind that this is essentially an oven, and it's an oven that depends on clean air flow. When you've got this lid up, you have no chimney, so to speak, on the fireplace, so the draw is gone. The temperature will just get higher and higher and higher. You won't have good control. So when you need to open the grill to access food, flip it, turn it, season it, do that. The rest of the time, keep it closed. That way you'll have good, clean control of the temperature through consistent airflow. That would be my tips on how to control temperature on a ceramic grill. For any other information, look at www.firesideoutdoorkitchens.com.
Fireside, the best grilling shop in town.